Welcome to Thank You Mommy. So today I'm going to talk about routine. Routine, I think is very important. It helps me manage with two kids. Some people may think it's better for them not to have a routine, but I think it helps a lot in keeping some of your sanity. So with my daughter, when she was younger, she used to go to bed like 7 o'clock, right? On the dot. She used to drop asleep by then. Like, as you put her to bed, 5-10 minutes, she out. But the older she got, you know, they have the phases where they go through where they basically don't want to sleep. And every night there's a fight not to sleep and giving trouble to sleep. But when they have a routine, I think it helps them to get into that mode. So by a certain time, they'll feel sleepy and they'll know, well, okay, their body knows it's bedtime. It helps me manage with two of them because baby is going to be 4 months on the 16th. And what day is today? And he has gotten down a routine, at least at night, mainly like probably about three months, more or less, around there. So he basically feels sleepy around 5-ish. He might take a little nap, doze off, a little cat nap. And then at 7, that's bedtime, right? And he might sleep maybe an hour or two, depending on how hungry he is. Because sometimes if he's so tired at 7, he wouldn't drink much and he'll go to sleep. And then he might get up maybe about 8 or 9 and drink, and then he'll drop back asleep. And then he'll go the 2 to 3 hours. Some nights, if he's really tired, he might go for 4 hours. My daughter, I get her in bed by between 7, half 7. It helps sometimes I put the two of them together at the same time, which is not always easy because she wants me to rock her, hold her, and I'm trying to get that rocking out of it because she actually stopped rocking her a long time, and especially when I was pregnant because she was getting heavy and I couldn't really rock her all the time. And I think because of baby in the picture, she started to want me to rock her, and I was like, but I don't even rock baby. So I tried to kind of like wean off that. I might pat her or tell her, you know, lie down next to me while I'm feeding baby. So it's kind of like, you know, one on one end and one on the next end, and it's a bit uncomfortable for my back, but that's what you gotta do sometimes, right? So with them, well, she goes to school, you know, so she would, you know, probably be worn out at school, and she doesn't like to nap, so most of the time she doesn't nap at school. At home, she never naps. If she's home on the weekend, never napping. And that's, yeah. you can't nap if she's not napping, you know? And baby doesn't nap for long sometimes, because sometimes if his sister is making a lot of noise and stuff like that, he may not nap for long. But in the night, I think the night is really to have a good routine. So I bathe them between 6 and 5:30, usually bathe baby first, and put them down to relax, bathe her, get them in the bed. If she has to get a bottle, baby to feed, and then they usually knock out and you get some time for yourself. So, with that, you know, it with her, I know when she was younger, it helped a lot, you know, getting her in that routine. Because, you know, they get up early, right? And you want them to be well rested, because when she doesn't go to sleep early, and if by some off chance we were out or something, I didn't really enforce the bedtime, and she gets up her usual early time. If she gets up later, it might be maybe an hour later. Like, she's up by 6-7 for the latest. And if it's an hour extra, maybe she's still cranky. You know, a 3-year-old, 2-year-old, you know, they gotta get their sleep, right? And I think You have to set your routine. I bathe baby twice for the day. You know, they feel refreshed when they take a bath before they go to bed. You know, so all of those things are important. So it's always good to have a routine with them. And you would be able to work around your schedule. So thank you for watching. Thank you, Mommy. And please subscribe.